Well, good evening.
Good evening, sir.
I haven't seen you in quite some time. It's a pleasure to see you here again.
It's pleasant to be here.
Thank you.
Father, Johnny came tonight to see Julia.
Well, that doesn't surprise me a great deal, daughter. Not a great deal.
Julia, huh? Not you and me. Come on, let's us go bye-bye. Linda, what's the idea of... Oh.
Julia, put on a wrap, please. We're going out.
Father, you won't mind if just tonight Johnny and I...
Please, close the door, Julia. I have something to say to you both. You insist in placing me in a position that I don't in the least relish. Come in, Ned, come in. Coming between two young people in love is furthest from my wish or intention. For love, true love, is a very rare and beautiful thing. Where are you going? Please sit down. And I believe its path, that is to say, the path of true love, contrary to the adage, should run smooth. But in order that it may, I am a man of 58 years and speak from long experience and observation. It is of paramount importance.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Yes?
If Pritchard Ames still want me, I'll go with them when we come back from our wedding trip. Say about March 1st.
Oh, Johnny.
I'm still not convinced. I still don't believe in it. But it's what Julia wishes, and I'm glad to defer to her wish.
And now, in heaven's name, may they be left alone, or shall we all move over to Madison Square Garden?
You say you're not convinced as yet?
Would you like me to lie to you, sir?
It's enough for me, Father.
Julia said a year or two. I'll go with them for 3 years. I'll work harder than I've ever worked before. I'll do everything I can to make a success of it. The only thing I ask is that if, at the end of that time, I still feel I want to quit for a while, there won't be any more objections.
Well, I doubt it. By that time, there'll be reason for any.
We'll have to see about that, sir.
Well, Father?
When is it you wish to be married?
As soon as possible.
Sooner.
Well, we'll have to talk this over. Now, the invitations will have to be out for 10 days at least. What would you say to 2 weeks from Wednesday?
Oh, that would be perfect.
Now, have you made any plans for your wedding trip as yet, may I ask?
We haven't any very definite plans. Mostly France, I expect.
Well, it's always wise to have definite arrangements for a honeymoon. Now, I would suggest that you land at Southampton and proceed straight to London. I'll cable my sister. She and her husband will be very glad to have you stay with them.
Oh, good heavens, Father.
He is Sir Horace Porter, one of the most influential men in British banking circles.
Father, I'm not sure.
Oh, Julie, you could scarcely go abroad and not stop with your Aunt Helen. Besides, it would save hotel expenses, and Johnny might learn something of British methods. Then I'll cable the Bouviers at Paris. He was expert advisor to the Minister of Finance during the late war. A very good man for you to know. They also will be very glad for to entertain you.
Well, I had thought of this as more as a lark than a business trip, sir. Well,
surely, there's no harm in combining a little business with pleasure, is there? I've never found there was.
They have a lovely place.
A week in London, a week in Paris.
1 hour in the Louvre.
10 days at Cannes. Ideal. Then you might sail from Genoa, return by the southern route. I'll arrange to have your house ready for you to go into March 1st.
Thanks, dear.
Well, what house is that, Julia?
Oh, Father is lending us the sweetest little place in 64th Street, dear.
I've also decided to turn the cottage at the Poplars over to you for the summers.
Now, there is a sweet little place. Only 15 master's bedroom.
Oh, Father, you shouldn't. You really should not.
Yeah.
Oh, wait till you see it, Johnny.
Yeah, this is not a deed of gift, you know. Not yet. No, no, not yet. Perhaps after you've occupied them 4 or 5 years, my hard old heart may soften.
Oh, listen to him. His hard old heart. Did you ever know of anyone so sweet?
Julia, I'm sorry, but I can't stand it.
Would you mind telling me what you mean?
Well, if we begin like this, loaded down with obligations, possessions, responsibilities, why, how would we ever get out from under them? We never would.
Uh-huh.
Well, no, you're very kind, sir, and generous, but but it's not for me.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
They tell me you've been away. Pleasant having you back.
It's pleasant to be back.
There's been rather a noticeable absence of snow these recent weeks, and
quite.
So,
Father, Johnny came tonight to see Julia.
Well, that doesn't surprise me a great deal, daughter. Not a great deal.
Julia, not you and me. Come on, Dada, let's go bye-bye.
Good evening, Johnny.
Get your coat, darling. We're going out.
Yes, dear. Oh, Father, could you explain to the Todds?
Please close the door. I wish to speak with you both. You insist on putting me into a position that I don't in the least relish. Who's that? Oh, come in, Ed.
Sorry, I just plucked the dirt.
Oh, come in. Sit down, son. Coming between two young people in love is furthest from my wish or intention. For love, true love, is a very rare and beautiful thing. Where are you going? Please sit down. And I believe that its path, that is to say, the course of true love, contrary to the adage, should run smooth. I'm a man of 58 years and speak from a long experience and observation. It is of paramount importance.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Yes?
If that position is still open for me at the bank, I'll be glad to take it.
Oh, Johnny.
I'm still not convinced. I still don't believe in it. But it's what Julia wishes. And I'm glad to defer to her wish.
You're not convinced, you say?
Would you like me to lie to you, sir?
Father, it's enough for me.
Julia said a year or two. I'll do everything I can to make a success of it. I have only one reservation. If at the end of that time I still think it's wise for me to quit, there won't be any objections.
I doubt if by that time there'll be reason for any.
We shall have to see about that, sir.
Well, Father.
When is it you wish to be married?
As soon as possible.
Now the sun shines once more and we're all friends again, eh?
And now what are your plans for your wedding trip, may I ask?
We hadn't any very definite...
Oh, it's wise to arrange even honeymoons a bit in advance. Now, let me suggest a little itinerary. You will land at Plymouth or Southampton and proceed straight to London. I shall cable my sister tomorrow. She and her husband will be delighted to have you stay with them.
Here, Sir Hobart Phillips, one of the most important men in British banking, sir.
Father, I'm
well,
not...
you could scarcely go abroad and not stop with your Aunt Helen, Julia. In addition, it will save hotel expenses, and Johnny can learn something of British methods. Then, I shall cable the Bovies in Paris. He's expert advisor to the Minister of Finance, a very valuable man for you to know.
Well, I had thought of this as a honeymoon more than a business trip, sir.
Well, there's no harm in combining a little business with pleasure, is there? I've never found that there was.
They have a lovely place, Johnny, just outside of Paris.
Now, a week in London, a week in Paris, 10 days in the south of France, ideal. Then you could sail from Genoa and return by the southern route. And I'll arrange to have your house ready for you to go into March 1st.
Oh, thanks, darling.
What house is that, Julia?
Father's renting us the sweetest little place on 64th Street. Oh, Johnny, wait till you see it.
This is not a deed of gift, you know, not yet. After you've occupied it for a while for some time, my hard old heart may soften.
Listen to him, his hard old heart.
Would you also arrange for the servants, Father?
Julia, I'm sorry, but I can't stand it.
Would you mind telling me what you mean?
I thought this was going to be a trial for a couple of years or so. But if we begin loaded down with possessions and obligations, we could never get out from under them.
Eh?
No. No. You've been extremely kind and generous, sir. But it's not for us.